Welcome to Real Chef Curry, and today we are going to make an amazing recipe. Before we get to our recipe, make sure that you click like and subscribe, punch that notification bell so that you can get updated on future videos. Today we are going to make an amazing authentic Amritsari Chole Bhature. Let's get to it.
So first step for our Chole Bhature is to take Kabuli Chana. What I did was I took 900 grams of Kabuli Chana yesterday night and I soaked it in water and tea bags. I added like 4 or 5 tea bags. I soaked them in water, and the reason I did that was because so that you get this dark brown color on the chole. Now after soaking it overnight, I drained them. And now we are all set to put them in the pressure cooker and just cook them till I think 4 or 5 whistles. Okay, so our chole are boiled, and now we are going. I took a big pan. In that, I have taken 4 tablespoons of oil. I'm going to just start the gas. Put it at a low or medium high. Sorry, medium high flame. And once the oil heats up a little bit, I am adding in there 1 teaspoon of jeera and 2 teaspoons of shahi jeera. So once our jeera and shahi jeera crackles, we'll start adding other ingredients. What I have done is I have kept ready 1 big onion. I have chopped it. I have chopped 1 big tomato, kept it ready. And I have kept 3 dried chilies ready. So first, once this crackles, chilies will go in, then the onions, and I have also taken 3 cloves of garlic, 4 green chilies, and this much piece of ginger. And I have put everything in the mortar and made a paste. If you don't want to make a paste, you can always buy the ready-made ginger garlic paste and green chili paste, but I prefer fresh, so that's what I have done. So our jeera has already started crackling, so I'm going to put in the red chilies in there. Now I'm going to put the paste off. I'm going to turn the flame to low and put the paste of ginger, garlic and green chilies. Now we'll add our onions and tomatoes. So onions will go first. Once they become little bit transparent, we'll start adding the tomatoes. So this, we are preparing the gravy for the chole. I'll put the flame again back to medium and I'll just stir this. So while we are waiting for the onions to get cooked, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 tablespoon of cumin coriander powder, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala, and 1 tablespoon of red chili powder. This you can reduce if you don't like spicy. You can maybe put 1/2 tablespoon instead of 1 tablespoon. Just I'm going to stir all of this. Our onion is also cooked, so I'm now going to add the tomatoes in it. While we are waiting for our tomatoes to be cooked, I'm going to add salt to taste. So first I will add just 1 tablespoon of salt. Sorry, 1 teaspoon of salt. Then once our gravy is done, I'll taste it, and then if I need more salt, I'll add. And I recommend you also do the same, because you don't want a salty food, right? So that's why. So while we are waiting for our tomatoes to cook, I am going to add something else. What I have done is I have taken 1/3 cup of dry tamarind and I soaked it in water for a couple of hours. Now I'm just going to mash it to make sure that all the sourness of tamarind goes in the water, and then I'm going to pass it through the strainer because we don't want any pieces of tamarind in it, but we want this tamarind water in our gravy. So I'm going to pass this through a strainer and I'm going to add the water in the gravy. So our tomatoes are cooked. You can see them, they are all mushy now. So we are going to add the tamarind water. So you see, this water again gives that dark color to the chole. And I recommend not to throw away the tamarind till the chole is completely cooked and you have tasted it, because if you feel that the sourness is missing, you can again add some water and strain it and put that water back in this. Normally when I do it, I don't need more. Once when I just use the water and that's all. I don't need more sourness, so. But it all depends on your choice, so I recommend to leave it. Also, one great tip I wanted to give here, that this tamarind which is left over, right, that is very good. It helps to clean the utensils, especially if you have any brass utensils, it helps to clean them. So you can always use it, leftover tamarind, to clean some utensils. It removes all the oil and everything from that. So we are done, and we'll just now we'll add some water and our chole. So first I'm going to add our chole, which are already cooked in the pressure cooker. And now I'm going to add at least 1 cup of water in this, and then put it on a slow flame and let it cook till everything mixes. So now we are adding 1 cup of water, and I have taken 2 tablespoons of besan. And what I did was, I took 1/3 cup of water, added 2 tablespoons of besan in it, and I have made a very thin besan paste. And I'm going to add that also in here, because that is going to help us to make our gravy thick. What I'm doing is, I'm going to run this besan also through the strainer, because sometimes the lumps are left and they form bigger lumps, which you don't want. So that's why I always run my besan through the strainer. So now, while this is cooking on a slow flame, we are going to start preparing for our bhature. We'll let this cook at least for 15-20 minutes, or till this becomes thick. You see, this watery part is left here. Instead of that, it should become very thick. And you have to stir it at least for first 2-3 minutes, because you don't want that besan which we added to form lumps. So now, while our chole is cooking, we made our dough for the bhature. So what we did was, I took 4 cups of all-purpose flour or maida, I added 1 tablespoon of salt in it, and I added 1/3 cup of oil. You can use any oil you want. And then, instead of using water, I use seltzer. Seltzer is nothing but carbonated water, which is not flavored at all, and it is unsweetened, no flavors, no color, nothing. Now, if you don't want to use seltzer, you can add yogurt in it and then knead the dough with warm water. But in that case, you will have to let the dough sit for at least 2-3 hours. Today, we don't have much time, and that's why I'm going to use seltzer in it. If you don't want to use yogurt or seltzer, you can always use Eno. What I prefer to make this at home, because chole bhature at home, because you know, you can control the quality of what goes into your chole bhature, because when you try to eat it in the restaurant, they are kind of very oily. So you can control the how much oil goes in here. So that's why we make it at home most of the time, and they turned out to be better than the restaurant. Quality is better, taste is better. So when I knead the dough, this consistency of the dough should be like this. And with 4 cups of all-purpose flour, we ended up using 1 1/3 cups of seltzer. So for our bhature, I have taken this much piece of the dough which we made, and I'm going to roll it. So the dough which I took is like of a size of a tennis ball, and I'm going to just roll it into a flat puri, or you can call it bhature. We have already put the oil on the flame. I'm just waiting for the oil to heat up, and once it heats up, I'm going to put the bhature in here. So the best way to check whether our oil has heated up or not is just to put a piece of dough in it, and if that rises immediately, then the oil has heated up. This one took a couple of seconds to rise, so we'll wait for at least 30 seconds before we taste it again. So our oil is ready, and I'm going to just gently remove this and put it in the oil to deep fry it. The flame is at medium high, and just press it a little bit, not much, but you see when you press a little bit, it just starts flip it. Again, let it cook from the other side. So it takes at least 2 minutes on each side for the bhature to cook, and you want it to be golden brown, like very light golden brown in color, and that's where you will know that it has cooked. So bhatura is ready. I'm going to just remove it from the oil, drain the oil properly, and put it on a plate with tissue. The plate has already a tissue on it, so just the tissue will soak up the extra oil. So you can see our chole is already cooked now. If you want, you can garnish them with little bit of ginger julienne and coriander. And if you want, you can just serve it as it is. So we are going to serve this and taste it and see how it turned out to be. But it smells delicious.
So everyone, here is our finished dish. We have an amazing bhature with our chole. So all we're gonna do now is we're gonna top the chole with some freshly cut onions. So you can choose to top it with whatever you want. You can chop it with some onions, some coriander, some grated paneer, some ginger, whatever you choose to top it with. So I'm just gonna top it with some fresh onions. You can also squeeze a little bit of lemon into the dish. And basically then you just dig in with your amazing bhature and the chole. So bon appetit, and see you guys next time.